All right, how's the feed, guy? Guys? Anybody in here? I see there's four souls, at least. So, we'll give a few more minutes and hopefully get some more people in here. So, this is the building it's in. It's up here in the third story. From everything I've gathered, this place has been, they've been up here since like the mid or late 70s. So, we have access to the whole third floor up there. It's quite a big building. You'll see once we get up there. And from my gathering, this was also one of the largest HO scale model railroads in Ohio at one time. Probably back in the, I would say probably early, you know, late 80s, early 90s or something like that. And it's located in Cambridge, Ohio, and this is 7th Street. So, we'll go up here and start walking this one door up here. This is my first time doing one of these, so this should be, hopefully it turns out all right. All right, and this door, and up, we gotta walk up these stairs. This is what sucks about this place, is the access. We gotta walk up these steps. So it's not very, you know, handicap accessible, which back in the day, you know, you really didn't have to worry about people suing you either. So that's what we're kind of worried about here with the location, is these steps right here, people fall down and then they want to sue you for $100,000, everything you have. So this is going to be the main building, or the main section. This was the entrance here. Is the feed fine for everybody? I got like two or three bars, so hopefully it's a good feed. This was the meeting room. Let's see if I can't find a light. I didn't have a light here. Hold on. Yeah, that added some light. Here's a kind of a yeah, hopefully a bunch of pictures and stuff like that of around the Cambridge area. So, and this was, and here is was a dispatcher panel at one time. I mean, it's still set up, but it doesn't work. And then all this right here leads over to another section, which we'll get to. So, let's go over here into the main room and have a gander. I'll grab this one chair here. Here's a little section, steel mill area that Roger's been working on. So, and this is the main room. Let me get this chair here. I don't want to get this chair set up. We'll take a peek over Cambridge. All right. There's what everybody was seeing the other day. There's Roger over there running the train. This guy is a great guitarist. I tell you, he performs as a soloist, but it sounds got a Marietta over here. We'll get to that here later. I'm gonna, we're going to start out here at Willard Yard. We're going to run a train around, so I mean, walk around this way, because I already got it. I already got the consist already hooked up and ready to go. This is a DC layout, so it's all blocked. There's 15 blocks. There's our train. We got three scale trains, SD45s. Good runners. I love them. I've had some Kato's and stuff like that, and they're right on par with, you know, quality and stuff like that. And this is Willard Yard. Some power sitting in the yard there waiting. Here's our caboose for our train. So this is all set in the mid to late 60s, I would say. No later than 1970 is the equipment allowed to be kept on the line. You can come up here and run whatever you want, it doesn't matter. And then you can just take it home with you. But yeah, let's get our train going, and I don't know how long this is going to take, so I got as long as this battery lasts in this phone. So we're running these, let me dunk under the layout here. This is the power supplies. All the blocks have these, so. They did have DCC here, but it was way in the early stages of DCC, and they had a bunch of problems with it and stuff. So, I'll walk back around here. We can get our train going here. Here's the controller for it. All right, come on. Oh, there she goes. She gonna, once we get past this area, right here, it goes into the next block, so she'll kick up the speed just a little bit. I already went through all the blocks and pre-plugged in everything, so the train's just gonna keep on going. And then here's Blacktop Mine. These mines were built by Jake Davis. They did an article in Model Railroading magazine in May of '89, and then a few of these mines that's on here is in that magazine, plus a brief description of this layout. Oh, hold on, I forgot to turn on the lights here. Give me a sec. Let's stop my train. All right, give me one sec here. I gotta go turn on these lights real quick. Hopefully, let me stand you here on this portal. Alright, there we go. We got lights now. I wish that light would have turned on, but power a train back up again. Kind of creep along here. And it goes up, it goes underneath here, it goes up. Kind of climbing a grade coming out of Willard here. And this is Zanesville area, Zanesville Yard. Here's the one video from where I shot at. This is a pretty neat area. There's a diamond. we'll run this train to everyone. Heck, if you guys want to see, you know, let me come back through and look at some more areas. Well, we got to walk all the way around here to get to our train. Here's some of the stuff we're dealing with around here as far as the ceiling. So let's go over here and catch our train. So this is Salzburg. This is a very neat town. I'm pretty sure Jake Davis is the one who modeled this too. I'm gonna stop my train because one of my lead engines is clear over there. Yeah. And yeah, we have these little quirks around here. I can go over here and get it. Let's see here. Oh, sorry about it. Boom, 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 boom. Get him back online here. Oh yeah, I could see. Yeah, that definitely is not gonna fly. I'll set him off over here somewhere for the time being. Wow. Hopefully we got enough power to make it. We'll see. Let's look at Salzburg here. I gotta set this controller here right away. A lot of neat scenes on here, a lot of detailed stuff. The time is just caught up with it though, with not a lot of people that come up here. Let's see if we can have a look this way. Hey, don't you know how to close the door, man? What the heck? Alright. Well, let's get our train going again. Hopefully we got enough power to make it over the hill. Around. Maybe we'll catch it up coming across this bridge right here. Yeah, over here we've had the ceiling come down again. Needs cleaned up. A little mine around there. All right, we're going to go down here in this area. This bottom area is called Stone Siding. used to be a backdrop here. We had to take the backdrop off and paint the windows to make the new owner of the building happy, because she didn't want to see the layout from down on the road. So we're going to have to replace the backdrops. A lot of stuff on here was scratch built. Some of these guys' talent was beyond words of what I can express. Like, wow. And a ceiling coming down right there, and there was a... used to have telegraph line running across there, and no more. Not now, anyways. This is Newark. Train's gonna wrap around and come back up there to Bluebell Siding. I'm gonna go and walk right here real quick. We got steel works. And a part of an extension that was being worked on, and of course, the ceiling has to have its way. So, definitely a work in progress. So, the train's going around there. Here we'll pick him up at the many a trains have passed these sidings up here. Well, there's the end of it. Let's keep on going. I'm gonna stop the train here. That way we can go over to Zanesville. Yeah, we'll stop it right there. Old signs that they had made at one time. Black Diamond Mine, or Black Diamond Coal Company, I should say. My bad. Coal dock. And we're going to go through that portal there, and that'll take us to Zanesville. We'll walk back around here. power company. Yeah, wish just like. Yeah, alright. Let's get our train going again. The watcher come through. Cross the TWVNO junction here. Slow her down here. Let her creep. Remember I was telling you it was back in the magazine in 89? Alright, here it is. And this is the area that was shot in right here. Alright. Now our train's headed around the corner here. Going across the trestle there at Blacktop Mine. Walk all the way around here.
And now we're going to change things up just a bit.
There's Cambridge. Let's go back over here. Get to our train. This is where one of the mines that's featured in that magazine was at one time. And the other one's still here. This right here, we called the Eastern Ohio Branch. We had to leave from Marietta to access it. And you'll see that here later. Anyways, our train went all the way around here, back over here now. Plug in here. This down here is East EO, Eastern Ohio Branch. Back to the coal mines. All right. we're parked here, we might as well go on a little tour ahead to Cambridge. So our train's gonna work our way around here. Let me move this thing out of my way. And we'll start head towards Cambridge here. Here at Cambridge, it splits off into two mains, south and northbound. Here's something you don't see on a lot of model railroads, is a telegraph line. I don't know whoever did that, but boy, they sure did have the patience to do it. It runs all the way up through there. And we get towards Cambridge here. And it runs clear that way too. Cambridge is like it might as well say it's a peninsula. It loops around itself one or two times. A big loop goes around and then comes back the other way, and we'll start making the grade and access, little access area back here. That's where I shot that photo at of them F units. We'll go underneath there and have a look. So whenever we go through that portal, we come back and we'll come through here. And it loops down and goes back around and back around this way again. Now here's a, I don't know if this was an old mine at one, but it probably was. But yeah, I would say this is all scratch built. Looks like they used like aluminum foil. Oh yeah. Pretty cool vantage point. There's another one. Let's see if we can zoom in here. Yeah. Yeah, I would say this was a mine at one time back in the, you can see the track that they had going back through there. Well, let's get out of here and we'll go back under. Well, it's quite warm up here. Whew, 85. And Cambridge Hill. This is every bit of 6 foot. Yeah, every bit of 6 foot. Let's get up here. So, I don't know if I can get a good view or not up here. How about this? Sorry, my camera's skills are horrible. Let's go over here to the other side of the peninsula. And this is Helper. You'll probably guess what happens here. This is a spectacular model railroad. This is where it comes back around. And it comes around here. Hobo Shack. And there's that signal bridge. Back around. That takes you back around, back to Helper. And somewhere underneath here, and actually, what's that? All right. Now, after you get through the portal there, Helper, you come out right here and you start climbing grade. I'm gonna set my camera right here, hopefully. Let's see if we can't get a good vantage point of this train going by, hopefully. If I can get it to stay. Not pointed up at the sky. Had to get the train going. did too much talking. Get up here and sorry for my poor camera skills. Into the tunnel she goes.
And then I'm going to have Bob Charles do his team absolutes. Find him on Facebook, the Bob Charles Band. But right now, here's Lonnie Mott doing his song, 1300 Miles. This train goes to Chicago.
Hi, Dan.
There's coffee across the street.
Alright, well, we might as well stay on this side because it's going to be coming around this way. Hi, Matt. Let's zoom in here a little bit. Well, nice if those signals was lit up. We'll watch it. Engines go by here, and then we'll go around and help her. Let's see if we can't get a crappy shot here, but yeah, I didn't turn out like I wanted. Oh well, we'll go over here to help her. Pow. Let's zoom out here. We'll be changing a block here. Plug in. Let's go over here and watch it climb the grade. Let's see if we spin out with these two scale trains or not. Mid-grade interlocking. poor light over here, so bear with me. And watch her come across this bridge here. Hopefully we can catch a decent view of it. And it's climbing the hill here, right in this area. This is where the ceiling fell down. It used to be a big stone arch bridge right here, made out of styrofoam somebody carved. It was neat. This darn ceiling up here fell down and took out a lot of the scenery. So we're getting ready to crest the top of the hill here. So, man, we're gonna be changing into another block. I better plug in. Yeah. Oops. Yeah, I wish there was enough trains running we could just do a stationary and just let it sit and you get watch a bunch of trains, but ain't enough people to have that happen. And start going down the hill now. Wait for it to come around here. Tunnel right here, and we're gonna go inside the mountain. So now we're inside the mountain and come back around. Yeah, it's gonna go around and come down here on these bottom tracks. Alright, let's go over here and catch it before it. I gotta plug into the next block, which is Marriott, or over here. Come through the tunnel here. I got to stop the train here. Calling this phone over here. I think Roger's back here in the back room. So, let's see here. 22. Well, maybe not. Are you clear? Alrighty. Alright, well, he's got the next block clear, so I'm gonna change it over here to northbound block. Start climbing a hill here. Yeah, I don't know why it stops here. Always does. I have to. Ah, my bad. Hold up. Boink. Oh yeah. Piece of plaster in the way. All right, I'm set. My bad. There we go. Let's see if we get her going again. There we go. This old layout, she needs some work. All right. Was double track through here at one time. And this is Marietta Yard. And we'll walk around Marietta here. And watch the train come up the grade here. Yeah, I ain't got her going fast enough to kick the lights on. Well, these are fantastic running engines. Smooth, silky smooth. All right, well, into the tunnel she goes, and this was the bathroom at one time, so you could sit in there and sit on the toilet and watch a train go by if you were lucky enough to catch one in there. Going here, and it's going back through to where the in there in the beginning of where I showed you the dispatcher panel. Oops, now how do I do that? Really? Oh, wait, there we go. Didn't want to see my ugly face. Here we go. We're gonna go into the next big area. I just got her creeping there, so now we're gonna walk all the way, we're gonna walk over here to the other side. So whenever we come up the steps, instead of making a right, we're gonna make a left. We'll go around. Walk around this way. And over here in Berg.
I know you don't, but I'm gonna
Beside Yelich, Robin Young, and there's our train.
Up and in. And Ryan Braun in 2011 were all stars. Silver Slugger Award winner.
Dunk of dirt. Am I out here?
Yep. Robin Young won the Silver Slugger and was named the AL's most valuable player in 89, but did not make that season AL All-Star team in 2012. Ron was an All-Star and a Silver Slugger Award winner, but finished second in the MVP voting for Giants Buster Posey. So they got very close.
Let's kick up the juice a little bit. There we go. Get the lights going. Yeah, that's one thing that sucks about DC. River DC.
Seeing a lot of ground balls here tonight. We're just going to make that very point. And that's a good sign from Anthony DeStefani.
Let's see here. There's the yard. There's Berg Yard. Engine House. Oh. Okay, watch your train here. Make sure we got the switch up here. And go around here. Now we're gonna walk around here real quick. And we're getting ready to enter the yard here. Let me plug in. Get my power under control here before it enters the block. There we go. My bad. Boy, Dan sure wishing signals worked. I might have to work on that, hopefully. Wait, I have to find the information to do it. How far are we into this? Oh man, we're almost an hour in, huh? All right, let's loop back in itself. And we pretty much arrived at the yard. But yeah, did you line me up, Raj? You got me lined up? All right, thank you. Slower down.
General Wholesale during these trying times. We've been serving the area for over 73 years and look forward to many more. From all of us at General us, no matter what. Be there for our veterans, no matter what. And I've got your back too.
I can, I will. Keep our family safe while you're away.
I can, I will. Think of you every night.
We're in this together. I got this.
I got this.
I got this. Take the first step.
There's no better time than now. Reaching out is a sign of strength. Visit realwarriors.net or call 800-874-2273.
At ABC Communications, we value the communities we serve, the relationships that we share, and the support we give each other in both good times and bad. And that's why we feel
that
in time of loss, it's important that information is shared quickly, accurately,
and they're going to fire me now. There we go. Try this again. I think this one's. There we go. Check your switches. Follow that back in there far enough, it'd take you back to that steel mill.
912 here in the
red. Alright. Nope. That shut it off.
Alright. No strikes.
Yep. That's it, guys. Be safe. Hope you enjoyed it.